What's really great about this kind of engineering, it's very, very visible. Lots of engineering isn't. It's very enclosed, it's a bit of a black box system. But here, you actually see it. You feel the flames when the boilers, we're stoking the boiler, you can feel the heat going through the pipes, you can see the engines moving. And that actually is quite inspirational because people can see what's happening. So we do have some younger volunteers here that are doing A-levels or at university and they're wanting to get experience, just want to know what engineering's about. And this gives them a hand-on opportunity where they're contributing to the museum. So that's one of the reasons why it's so important to have places like this museum, because you see real-life, breathing engineering going on. Actually taking something that didn't work and to take it from that situation to a point where we're actually having our first public event, that's incredibly satisfying.
These particular engines are now absolutely unique. It's important for people to see these engines back in steam. There's nothing like them anywhere else in the world. This is how it used to be done before we had electric motors. And they're an important stage in technology.
I got involved with the Cambridge Museum technology back when I was 16. I used to be a rower on the river, used to row past the museum and wondered what was going on at the place, intrigued what was going on. The engine just rocks backwards and forwards. It doesn't do anything other than rotate one way and then the other way. It's not like conventional steam engine that rotates. And it's part of Cambridge's history, really. You know, this is the sewage pumping station that used to pump the sewage away from Cambridge. So for it to be back in steam again and showing the public of how it used to pump the sewage away is something that really needs to be seen by the public.